Sorry about that. This is, let me see, yes, part eight of the Caroline interview with Colin Dale and Dale Richardson. yes, I've just been getting out my body stocking.
On radio as such, I think he was asking 450 quid or something, if my memory serves me right. He paid about 700 for it at the time. Doesn't seem possible he could buy a brand new vehicle, does it?
No, quid. Not at all.
But anyway, we put sawdust in the gearbox. And he sold it.
Oh, great stuff. Okay, back to some music. Here's Carl Perkins, one of your favourites.
Great. Love Carl.
Stuff back to Colin just a moment. Yorkie Jim said that last week he had to go out and missed the competition result. It was Jodie Reynolds on last week's competition, Jim. Back to this week, Derek Carr, that's Deccan Donny, absolutely correct. Stu Campbell, you've got it right as well. And Eddie Fisher in Germany, absolutely correct. Another one from Germany now. And this is Gerd Stassen. Yes, absolutely correct. So lots and lots of correct answers coming in for the competition this evening. Okay, back to Colin Dale now. And again, we're on those seaports. And of course, you're saying about these long hours. I mean, what was it like sleeping out there? Was that okay? I mean,
yeah, it wasn't bad. We had these sort of bunk beddy things, these, canvas beds. On metal frames,
yes,
which were easy to get out there. They were fairly light. We slept on those. We
what about eating?
Oh yeah, we had mostly tin food.
Okay.
We had sort of, you know, these things where it's like stew in a tin.
Oh yes.
Baked beans, bread. We had bread, toast, that sort of stuff. You know what I mean?
Were there toilets on the towers or not?
Yeah, and we used them.
Oh, you did, right.
Yeah, we actually used them, right. Because they just dropped straight into the sea.
Right, so if you were a passing boat...
Yeah, so don't go underneath the gun tower. Otherwise...
Good job
cows don't fly.
Was there a story that there was a problem with the RAF or something? What was that about? Or?
Oh, yeah, that was me, yeah. Yeah, you're bringing it all back, yes. I was taken ill with food poisoning. And there was only the two of us on there. There was Brian, Paul, and myself. And Reg had gone back to shore. It was sort of the weekend, you know.
Yeah.
He said he'd be away for 3-4 days. We'd just have to get on with it, which we were doing quite nicely, until I was taken ill. I had some Duff salmon, tin salmon, not fresh caught.
Yeah.
And I was taken ill, so I was so bad. I was screwed up, you know, totally screwed. And Brian said, we're going to have to do something. He said, we're going to have to get you off. There was a gale blowing outside, so they couldn't get a boat out to us.
Okay.
So he put out a mayday, and lo and behold, a helicopter from RAF Manston came to the gun towers, hovered above the gun towers.
Yeah.
Come down into the gun towers, got hold of me, dragged me up the stairs onto the roof, which is like concrete, flat concrete roof.
Yeah.
Stick this harness around me, and they winch me up into this helicopter.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, and they take me to Margate Hospital. Now, I don't know what Margate Hospital was like today, but in those days it was built like in a U shape.
Okay.
And they landed the helicopter dead in the centre of the U, if you can imagine.
Sure.
These guys come running out with a stretcher. Nurses, some lovely nurses there. Oh, there were some lovely nurses in
Margate. Remember your wife.
Oh, yes, they were lovely. Anyway, they took me in there, and they put me in a ward with several other guys. And, of course, the next day... Oh, that night, yes, I nearly forgot. The reporters came in. They allowed the reporters into this sort of...
reception?
Yeah, sort of a reception area. They let them in, and they took photographs and all that. And there was a sister... I think her name was Anne Scotchmore, and she was attending to me, and then they put me in this room with these other guys. Well, next day, I couldn't believe it. They had radios, obviously, and it was on the news every hour. And also, I was told it was on the television. I didn't see that, but it was on the television all day long about this disc jockey who'd been winched off the gun towers with food poisoning.
Well, there's more publicity for Dave.
Well, sure. Yeah, exactly, yes. That did create quite a stir because it was in all the newspapers again.
Yeah, incredible.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
It's hard to imagine, like, now, you know, doing something like that, you know. I mean, are you ever tempted? I mean, I know that you're not a young man anymore. Have you ever thought about going back out to those?
I'll be 74 in January.
74, incredible.
Yeah. You haven't been back there for 50 years.
But do you ever get a yearning to I
fully intend, if I live that long, in 2014, it'll be 50 years, won't it?
Yeah.
I fully intend going back to the gun towers. They do trips out there, you know.
Do they?
Yeah, and I'm going to take myself and Joan... And if I can find the odd reporter, and I mean very odd,
yes,
I'm going to go out there, take some photographs, and just revisit again. I ain't climbing up no ladder, because I doubt if it'll be there.
Yeah, you know.
Part 9 coming up, the Caroline interview.
It does bring back strong memories, you know.
Sure.
And when I start sort of thinking about it, I think that David is gone, Reg is gone, Brian is gone. Jeff Pottinger is still alive.
Is he?
He works out in the Middle East as a pilot. He's training Arab guys to fly planes.
All right.
I jokingly said to you, mate, there's no bombs in those planes.